Hey, coming to you with the eighth excerpt reading from my third published book, Christianity, the Way Jesus Lived It. And it's from chapter 8, titled, Have a Benefit. And as I always say, if you're going to have a fit, make it a benefit. Hey, thank you to everybody who has subscribed to the channel. I'm almost at 100 with a lofty goal of getting to 1,000 so I can do some live streaming on occasion. And if you haven't yet subscribed, please do. Also, like, comment, and share these videos, both the short ones and the longer version. Have a benefit. So many of God's people spend most of their time having fits of doubt, unbelief, anger, disappointment, depression, and many other unhealthy expressions. Is it no wonder that the world has yet to be won to God? Here is a thought. Can you imagine going to work for a corporation that has as part of its benefit package full medical coverage with no employee contribution? That would be awesome, wouldn't it? So there you are working for this incredible company for almost a year and you get sick. You call in to report to your superior that you will not be coming into work because you must see a doctor for your problem. Your superior informs you that you will have to talk to the person in charge of benefits to find out your rights under the coverage. While speaking to this person, you are told that he is sorry to have to inform you, but you cannot activate your benefit package. The reason you are given is that in your file, there are some reports that say you have not fully grasped your responsibilities at the company, and you have made several key mistakes. You say to the person in charge that you realize you've made some mistakes, but you did go to your superior and discuss these with him. And he told you not to be too concerned as you were still new at the job and were still learning the ropes. The person in charge of benefits tells you he understands, but that doesn't change the fact that even though all had been noted in your file, you cannot activate your benefits and go to the doctor. He informs you that you can go to the doctor, but that you will have to pay for all of the costs that are incurred. This scenario is ridiculous, isn't it? Yet this is exactly how many Christians feel about the benefit package they have as believers in Jesus Christ. Or maybe they are not sure what benefits they do have. Or even worse, they don't even realize they have a benefit package. It is sad, but very true. Many Christians have no clue what benefits they have in the kingdom of God. They believe that God is a tightwad. They may believe this due to ignorance on their part, but the fact still remains many of the benefits that belong to Christians go unused for one reason or another. What are our benefits? That is a very good question. I have a very good question for you. If you are a Christian and have been one for more than a few years, why don't you know what your benefits are as a citizen of heaven? Where can we find our benefits? Well, they are found throughout the entire Bible. I want to show you where you can find a group of them in one place. This is Psalms 103. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgives all your iniquities, who heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from destruction, who crowns you with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfies your mouth with good things, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. In these verses of scripture, we are told to bless, which means to praise, thank, salute, and kneel before the Lord three times. To bless God is so vitally important to activating the benefits he has provided for his people. Thankfulness is a prerequisite for implementation of so much in the economy of God that we all would do well to practice it more often. Then we are told to not forget all his benefits. After all, how can a person enjoy a benefit he or she does not even know they possess? If we forget or neglect what God has provided, we obviously will not be very thankful toward him for them. Then the psalmist lists six benefits that are ours as covenant children of God. And I'm not going to go through all of them. I'm just going to go through the first two. First, we have forgiveness. This is not just ordinary forgiveness. We have been forgiven all of our iniquities. That is much different than simply having our sins forgiven. Picture a fruit tree with me for a moment. If the sins we commit are the fruit on the tree, then the iniquities in our lives are the roots of the tree. Iniquities are those things that cause us to commit sins against God. It has the connotation of bending toward evil. Just like roots spread out toward moisture, so the iniquities in our lives spread out toward evil influences that result in sin. These iniquities are generally passed down through our forefathers and foremothers. They are sometimes called generational sins. Some of the things we do, we have no idea why we do them. This could be the result of iniquity in our life. God has already dealt a death blow to these powerful forces through the blood of Jesus, and we have already been forgiven of them. John the Baptist said this amazing statement, "The axe is already laid at the root of the trees." We desperately need to know this truth for us to gain the victory over the fruit of sin in our lives. James tells us that we are led into sin by our own desires. Where did those desires come from? More than likely, they were handed down to us from our forefathers. We were born with a sinful nature that is bent toward sin. The second benefit is we find that we have been healed of all our diseases. Getting back to Psalms 103, we have noticed the verb tense, or have you noticed the verb tense that has been used so far? Let us look at them again. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgives, present tense, all your iniquities, and heals, present tense, all your diseases. Why is this so important? Because God is the great I am. He is not the great I was. God will forever be the ever-present help in times of trouble. He is always ready to forgive and to heal. There is never a time when he refuses to forgive or heal a person who comes to him, excuse me, in faith and with thanksgiving for what he has provided. That is so vitally important for us to grasp. How can we minister effectively to any hurting person if we do not honestly believe this with all our heart? The only way to keep doubt and unbelief out is to crowd it out with faith in the unchanging Lord of love and life. God is love and he is life, and he wants to give his life to us because he loves us. He loves you. And if you have any dis-ease, dysfunction, disability in your life, Jesus paid so that you can activate the benefit package. What is it that you need? Jesus has already paid for it. He said, "It is finished," which in the Greek means paid in full. Amen. Thank you again to everybody who has subscribed, liked, commented, and shared. And if you haven't done that, please do. God bless and peace in.